Good morning all of you. Today is day 31 of our Kar IBPS 2019 FATEH 6 month preparation plan for IBPS exams 2019. The topic for today is caselet DI. So let's start. Directions for question number 1 to 5 are: read the data carefully and answer the questions. A company is the producer of bottles and it used to sell bottles at production cost through distributor on a condition that on selling the stock of every 50 bottles, distributor will get rupees 1000 as commission. The distributor is responsible to sell all those bottles to retailers. If distributor marks the bottles at the price which is 30% above the production cost, that is cost price, and allows a discount of Y%, distributor sells total of X bottles which is 40 less than total received stock by distributor. Total production price of whole stock of bottles received by distributor to sell to retailers is rupees 7.8 lakhs. The commission received by distributor is rupees 7000 and he made a profit of rupees 1.4 lakhs on selling the bottles. Okay, so there is a company which is producing bottles and is selling those bottles at production cost through a distributor, and on a condition that if this distributor he sells 50 bottles, he will get a commission equal to rupees 1000, and further this distributor will sell these bottles to retailers, and after that the whole story belongs to the distributor only. So let's start. It has been given that this distributor, he earned a total commission of rupees 7000. A commission of rupees 1000 is earned on selling 50 bottles. So commission of rupees 1 will be earned on selling 50 by 1000 bottles applying the unitary method. So a commission of rupees 7000 will be earned on selling 50 by 1000 into 7000 bottles, which is nothing but equal to 350 bottles. This means what? That this distributor sold a total of 350 bottles. So number of bottles sold by the distributor is equal to 350. Now this says that distributor sells total of X bottles which is 40 less than total received stock by distributor. So number of bottles received by distributor is what? 350 plus 40, that is 390, because it says that he sold X bottles which is 350 and 350 is 40 less than 390, hence the number. Now going further, it has been given that the production price of whole stock of bottles received by distributor is rupees 7.8 lakhs, which means the production cost of these 390 bottles, or we can say it like this, CP of 390 bottles is equal to 7.8 lakhs, which is 78 followed by 40. So CP of one bottle from here comes out to be what? 2000 rupees, right? So CP of one bottle is equal to rupees 2000. Further, it has been given that the distributor marks the bottles at the price which is 30% above the production cost. So mark price of one bottle is 13% above cost price, means 1.3 of 2000, which is nothing but equal to rupees 2600. So this is MP of one bottle which is equal to rupees 2600. Further, it says that the distributor made a profit of rupees 1.4 lakhs on selling the bottles. How many bottles did the distributor sell? Distributor sell a total of 350 bottles. So selling price of, total selling price of these 350 bottles would be equal to what? Cost price of 350 bottles plus the profit made by the distributor. Cost price of 350 bottles would be number of bottles into cost price of each bottle, that is rupees 2000, plus profit is what? 1.4 lakhs. This total is what? 35 2 times is 70. 70 followed by 40. This is what? 7 lakh. So 7 lakh plus 1.4 lakh, which is nothing but 8.4 lakh. So 8.4 lakh is the selling price of 350 bottles. So selling price of one bottle would be equal to 8.4 lakhs means 84 followed by 40 divided by 350 bottles. So 7 5 times, 7 12 times, 000, 5 to 10, 2400 rupees. So this is the selling price of one bottle, which comes out to be rupees 2400. So what else remains now? Nothing else remains now. We have used all the information that has been given to us. Also, there is one thing more. It says that the distributor allows a discount of Y percent. This thing. So we need to calculate it for Y. Let us see. Selling price of one bottle is rupees 2400. Mark price of one bottle is rupees 2600. So the discount offered is what? Discount offered is MP minus SP, which is equal to 200 rupees. So discount of 200 rupees over the mark price of 2600 rupees. This is the discount percent, which is equal to Y percent. So that let's write it Y. This is in 200. Goes out 13. 100 by 13 is equal to what? 100 by 13 is 7 whole 9 by 13 percent. So value of Y is equal to 7 whole 9 by 13 percent. Now let's move on to questions. Question number one is, what is the value of Y? Okay, so it is asking for the value of Y. Value of Y we found out is 7 whole 9 by 13. Among the options, we have option B as 7 whole 9 by 13. Hence, it is the correct choice. Question number two, what will be the ratio of Y percent of 100 is to X plus 40? Okay. Y percent is what? This thing, 7 whole 9 by 13 percent. Or this is equal to 100 by 13 percent. So 100 by 13 percent is 100 by 13 into 100. Of 100 means into 100. This ratio upon X plus 40. Value of X is what? We saw value of X is 350. So 350 plus 40 is 390. This is the ratio we need to find. Let us solve this. This goes out 100 by 13 and then into 390 here. This goes out 10 by 13, 9 times is 117, carry 11, 13, 3, 39, and then 39 and 11 is 50, 507. 10 is to 507 is the required ratio. This has been given in option D, hence it is the correct choice. Question number 3 is asking, instead of Y, distributor allow 10% discount on one bottle, then percentage of profit of distributor. Okay, so in case of Y, we have now got 10%, which means Y is not equal to 100 by 13% now. It is equal to 10% now. Mark price of one bottle was rupees 2600. If we apply 10% discount, then SP will become what? SP will become 90% of this, which is equal to 9654, 9218 and 5 is 23, 2340 rupees. In this case, the discount give profit is what? CP of one bottle was equal to 2000 rupees. Was it? Let's go back and see. CP was equal to 2000 rupees. Yes, 2000 rupees. So profit here is what? SP, that is 2340 minus 2000. So profit is equal to 340 rupees. We need to find profit percentage, new profit percent. So profit of 340 over CP of 2000. This is simply what we need to find out. This goes out. 17% is the required profit. This has been given in option A, hence it is the correct choice. Question number 4. If company added given commission in cost price and he gives a stock of X plus 450 bottles to another distributor who sold all stock, then find new cost price of one bottle. Okay. x value of x is what 350 we saw. 350 plus 450 is equal to 800. So this company, it added given commission in cost price now, and it gave away 800 bottles to another distributor who sold all these 800 bottles. Then we need to find cost price of one bottle. Cost price of one bottle is what, rupees 2000 initially. Now it has been given that on selling 50 bottles, the commission which is earned is rupees 1000. On selling one bottle, commission earned would be rupees 1000 by 50. So on selling 800 bottles, commission earned would be 1000 upon 50 into 800. 52 times 0, 16,000 rupees. This is the total commission earned. Now if this is added to CP, to the cost price, then on 800 bottles, this commission has been generated, which means if I divide this by 800, then I will get the commission per bottle, or what we can say, rupees 20 will be added to the CP of each of the bottles, which means eventually we will have the new CP as the previous one, that is 2000 per bottle plus this 20 rupees per bottle, which is 2020 rupees. Hence option B is the correct choice. Question number 5. If distributor allowed two successive discounts of 5% and 12.5% on mark price, then find the profit made by distributor on selling of one bottle. Okay. Mark price of one bottle is, we know from the data, rupees 2600. Now discount of 5% means the remaining is 95%, and 95% is 19/20. Discount of 12.5% means discount of 1/8, so remaining is 7/8. So MP, that is 2600, into the fraction that is remained, 19/20 after the first discount, and then the fraction that is remained after the second discount into 7/8, this is the final selling price. Let us solve this. It goes out to 130 times is this. 13790 1 910 into 19 upon 8 19 0 19 1 19 carry 1 19 9 times is 171 170 1 and 1 is 172 divided by 2 8 2 16 8 1 8 48 8 6 48 8 1 8 this much rupees 2161.25. This is the selling price of one bottle. Also cost price of one bottle was equal to rupees 2000 from the data. The difference between SP and CP is what? The profit. So this difference is what? Rupees 161.25 rupees. And this is what we need to find out. We need to find the profit made per bottle. This has been given in option A, hence it is the correct choice. Moving on to question number 6. Directions for question number 6 to 10. Read the below given passage carefully and answer the following questions. Okay, so another data set has been given. It says there are two villages, village A and village B, whose population is 800 and 1200 respectively. 30% of total population of village A is farmers and 60% of total population of village B is farmers. Ratio of male to female farmers in village A and B is 2:3 and 7:5 respectively. So we have got two villages, village A and village B. 30% of total population of village A is farmers. Okay, so let us write here. This is the number of farmers in both the villages. 30% of 800 for village A. 30% of 800 is equal to 240. So number of farmers in village A is equal to 240. Similarly, 60% of total population of village B is farmers. 60% of total population, that is 1200, is 720. So number of farmers in village B is equal to 720. Now ratio of male to female farmers in village A is 2:3. Okay. Among these farmers, the ratio of male to female for village A is 2:3. So number of male farmers in village A would be equal to 2/5 of 240, which is what? 5, 4 times is 20, 5, 8 times is 40, 20, 2 into 48 is 96. So this is 96, and the remaining 3 into 48, 144 is the number of female farmers in village A. For village B, the ratio of male to female farmers is 7:5. So number of male farmers would be 7/12 of 720, which is equal to 420, and the remaining is the number of females, which comes out to be 300. Let's move on to questions now. Question number 6 is, total number of female farmers from both villages is what percent more or less than total population of village B? Okay. Number of female farmers from village A is 144. That from village B is 300, their total becomes 444. 444 is what percent more or less than 1200, which is the population of village B? The difference between 1200 and 444, 1200 minus 400 is 800, 800 minus 44 is 756. So 756 is what percent of 1200? This is what we need to find out. 6 times is 72, 12 3 times is 36. 63% is the required percentage. Hence option B is the correct choice. Question number 7. What is the ratio of male farmers from village A to female farmers from village B? Okay. Number of male farmers from village A is 96, and female farmers from village B is 300. So we need to find the ratio of 96 is to 300. This is 339, 326, 300 times 48, 425. So 8:25 is the required ratio. This has been given in option A, has the correct choice. Question number 8. Total male farmers from both villages are how much more or less than total population of village A? Okay. Total population of village A is 800, and total farmers, male farmers from both the villages is 420 plus 96. So we need to find the difference between 420 plus 96 and 800, the difference between these two. 420 plus 90 is 510. 510 plus 6 is 516. So 800 minus 516, this is the required difference. 800 minus 500, 300 minus 16 is 284, which means option E is the correct choice. Question number 9 is, male farmers in village A are what percent of female farmers in village B? Okay, so we just saw male farmers in village A is what? 96, and female farmers in village B is 300. So 96 is what percent of 300? This is what we need to find out. So simply this is what? 32%, which means option D is the correct choice. Question number 10. What is the average of farmers from village A and village B? Okay, farmers from village A and village B. Total number of farmers from village A is 240, and that from village B is 720. So 240 plus 720, we need to find their average. 240 plus 720, there are two villages, so their average is divided by 2. 120 plus 360, this is nothing but equal to 480. This is the required average number of farmers. This has been given in option C, which makes it the correct choice. Moving on to question number 11. Question number 11 is, we have been given the directions for 11 to 15. What should come in place of question mark in the following questions? Okay, so question number 11 to 15 are based on simplification. I would call this question mark to be X for the sake of easy writing. Question number 11 is 75% of 450. 75% is 3/4. 3/4 of 450 plus 25% is 1/4 of 850. This is equal to value of question mark, that is X. We can take out 1 by 4 common. So 3 into 450. And what else can be taken out as common? 10 can be taken out as common, and then 5 can be taken out as common. Okay, so this is it. So 50 is here. 50 9 times is 450. 9327 plus 50 17. So this is 17 equal to x. 50 by 4 multiplied with 27 and 17. This is 44. 11 times. So this is 550. This is the value of x, which means option C is the correct choice. Question number 12. X equal to square root of 273 minus 119 into 3. This is what? 357 plus 280. This is equal to 280 plus 270 is 387 is 15, yes, right, carry one. 553 minus 357, okay, this is right. Then this is what, this difference is 13 minus 7 is 6, 14 minus 5 is 9, 1. Root of 190, square root of 196 is 14, hence value of x is equal to 14, which means option A is the correct choice. Question number 13 is 4 to the power question mark, that is 4 to the power x equal to 32 into 512 divided by 128. So this is what, like this, into 8. So this becomes what, 32 4 times is 128, 4 2 times is 8. So 4 to the power x is equal to 1024. Okay. 1024 is, we know, 2 to the power 10. 4 to the power x can be written as what? 2 squared to the power x or 2 to the power 2x. If we compare these two, we can say that 2x is equal to 10 or x is equal to 5. Hence, option E is the correct choice. Question number 14. X plus 2 whole 1 by 3 plus 5 whole 1 by 6 minus 7 whole 8 by 11. Okay. So 2 plus 5 is 7, 7 minus 7 is 0. So x plus 0, then plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6 minus 8 by 11. This is equal to 3 plus 8 is 11 plus 3 by 11 plus 1 by 2. Okay. So x finally is equal to this 11 plus 3 by 11 plus 8 by 11 is 11 by 11, then plus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6, like this. This is 1. 11 plus 1 is 12. 12 plus 1 by 2 minus this. LCM is 6, 3, 2, 6, 1. 3 by 6 this is, which is 1 by 2. So this goes out. So finally x is equal to 12, which makes option C the correct choice. Question number 15, and this is the last question for today's quiz. It says 8 whole 1 by 3% of 240 equal to 25% of x minus again 8 whole 1 by 3% of 384. So I can write it like this: 8 whole 1 by 3% of 240 plus 384 from here. This total is equal to 25% of x. 25% is 1 by 4. 1 by 4 of x. 83, 24 plus 1 is 25. So this is 25 by 3% or 25 by 300 into this thing is 4. 8, 4 is 12. Carry 1. 6, 24 equal to x by 4. 25 1 times, 25 1 times, 25 2 times. Okay. Am I right? 25 1 times, 25 2 times, yes. Then 4 3 times is 12. 3 2 6, 3 0, 3 8, 24. Value of x comes out to be equal to 208, which means option E is the correct choice. So this is the end of today's quiz. Thanks and have a nice day.